Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for sticking around. We're celebrating tonight Revival's second birthday. So thank you, Landon Bushell, for opening the set. We're going to do a live question and answer a couple times through the set, so plug your questions into the feed. But for now, let's start with some Jay Gilday Band. Thank you, fellas.
Hey-o! Happy birthday, Revival House. That was a little song for people walking around with masks, and all you can see is their eyes most of these days. Right? Right? Hello, World Wide Web. This is weird. You can see me, I can't see you. I'm picturing you all in your jammies on your couches. What do you got? Thank you.
baby, even in a dollar tie. Moving with the winter, yes, and I know she's right. She's a mean girl. She's a mean girl. Leave a little piece of my heartache out of time. Cooling with the spring now, seeing if the summer rides. She's a mean, mean girl. She's a mean.
Oh, geez. Has anybody paid their taxes? Boo! Sorry, I know it's a sore subject right now. Jesus, even taxes are weird this year. Keeping things interesting, hey? This one's for the government.
fucking opening these days. Well, there was no one around now, looking for to see if it's open to find my life. But of course I get downtown. Of course that bank's open, boy, even if everything else isn't.
I got some feelings in these times. I'm super happy that Tyson and Andrea invited me out to play here. I'm so glad that you guys are keeping at it and don't fucking give up. Thank you for that. And all you out in the World Wide Web there, please go to the donate page. We got a struggle here and not a ton of support for live music. So give what you can.
Feel a little piece of your soul. calling on the days, waiting in a piece of my eyes. I love that you're so here. Some alone days, piecing in a love and you fight. Oh, love that's chills. Chills a lot of time. Love that you lose. Chills a lot of days. Oh, love that you feel. Feeling the love. Love that you steal.
Baby, love is alive when you run to me.
Oh, jeez. Hey, what do you know, Tyson?
All right, great. First, well, I guess it's not a set. We're breaking this into thirds, maybe? We're going to start with the first Q&A, though. And first off, introduction.
Oh, okay. On my left here, you're right. Mr. Andrew Stewart on the bass. The longest hair in the Edmonton Central region. And behind me, I got Mr. Jeff O'Brien. Of the Big Dreamer Jam fame and Bad Buddy fame. Oh, Bad Buddy, I love you kids. And we got Mr. David Aid on the keys. A killer. Thanks, David. He's a killer. And I'm Jay Gilday. And I'm from Yellowknife in the Northwest Territories. But I've been making my home in Edmonton since, 95, 96, 97, somewhere in there. And the first concert I ever saw here was Def Leppard with this guy.
Wait, you're jumping ahead in the questions here. So we actually had a shout out online from White Horse, but we also had one from Peru.
Oh! I think that's a friend of Dave's. Dave, you want to say hi?
That's hi to Melvin. Catalina and Stella, they're all watching from Peru.
Yeah. That's excellent.
You and I are best friends now, Dave. We use the same mic.
Hey, I've been isolated for like a week.
So I got a couple standard questions. How does it feel to be back on stage right now?
You know, we were talking about this earlier. It's pretty much the same, you know. There's nobody here. So it's not the first time we played to an empty club, but no, it's weird. We're way out of shape. I will say that the fucking drive is there. I love playing with these guys and don't get to do it very often anymore, so it's pretty sweet.
That's awesome. Well, you guys are sounding amazing, so it's not showing. If you feel out of shape, it's sounding great. So, hold on. Sorry, I'm just reading a question here. Every musician has played to packed houses and empty rooms. Mm. Do you guys still feel the presence with an online audience?
Yes-ish. Yes-ish. Yeah, I'm feeling the presence a little bit, but it's honestly one thing that I've always tried not to think about, even in live shows where it's not streaming, like people got their cameras out or whatever, and we play shows, and I'm like, don't think about those people doing whatever they're doing out there, but I don't know, it's different.
Different is right. I think that's, you know, the answer to a lot of questions we have these days. Jay, so I'm just asking a question, as if I don't know anything about your career here. we started watching you when you were performing solo and for a fair time. So how long has it been? Can you tell the audience how long you've been playing with a band, sorry?
Oh, geez. Andrew, when did we start playing this rock and roll show? Talking to the mic.
2013, I think.
2013? Yeah. 2013-ish, and we've had a rotating crowd of people playing different instruments. But I think, Jeff, we nailed down in about... 4 or 5 years ago, and David shortly after that, and that's sort of been the core group for a while. We have Dave Babcock with us sometimes on horns, but Audrey Ochoa was with us that was great. It was after that record that I made with Stu Kirkwood that we I started playing with a ton more people and seeing what I really needed in the band, and I found out that these guys are what I needed. So.
All right, so here's a question on the fly, because he said playing with a ton of people. Mad Dogs. How Hey-o. Many people do you have on stage when you're playing with the Mad Dogs?
Mad Dogs! Mad Dogs! We typically don't have less than 15.
When you guys played at the fair.
When we played at the fair, there was 19 or 20 of us on stage.
19 or 20.
Cheers to the Mad Dogs. We were supposed to play. It took me 2 years, but I finally got us a gig at my hometown in Yellowknife at Folk in the Rocks this year. And then shit hit the fan. And that's killing me, because I was going to get to bring that whole group up there and show all my family at home what I've been doing all these years. And because I was going to get to bring these guys to, or at least some of you to play in my band. And then Kalli Cardinal is going to play with her band, and then Dana Wiley is going to play with her band. We were going to use the Mad Dogs band for all that, but it's all there was a bunch of ringers in the band that we were going to fill out the festival with. It was great.
So basically, you're bringing the whole festival with you.
We essentially were filling out the whole festival. It was going to be monstrous.
Well, it still is going to be monstrous. Hopefully next year. I'm going to leave it at that for now. Let's get back to music, and I'll interrupt you guys again here shortly.
Don't mind if you do. Not a big story behind this one. I just wanted to write one that where I sounded like the boss.
Every time I gotta go away, which of my tears lifted my eyes.
She's been good to me. Thank you very much. Oh, boy. We're going to get back to our roots a little bit here.
Everything has got to be just like
you, boys. Thank you for going through that with me. That was a kicking off point for you and I, at least, and definitely Jeff. How do you feel about the Beatles, Dave? They all right. I gotta say that this next song was one of the first songs that I wrote specifically because of the guitar that I was playing, and it was definitely one of the first songs I wrote on a Stratocaster. And this is not the first Stratocaster I've owned, though it is my favorite. I did own a Fender. Like a 60s reissue Stratocaster that was fantastic. It was baby blue, and it was a rosewood fretboard. God, I like that guitar. Somebody out there's got it. Thank you. Oh, boy. Sensitive music, everybody. Huh? Yeah, I don't know. We could do one and then they can ask the questions. Oh, are you going to do it now? Let's do it now. Run! Tyson's got more questions for us. Why do you put a capo on a Stratocaster, Jay?
Why do you put a capo on a Stratocaster? All right, so I missed a note before our last question period ended. Jay, stop swearing, please.
Oh, yeah.
That's I believe, from your wife here.
That's for my wife? That's funny. I definitely will do that. I had a CD release recently last fall, and I had I invited the Imaginarium guys to come out. I don't know if you've ever seen those guys, but they do a kids show, a puppet show, and they also do an adult puppet show. And that's what I asked them to do when my kids were there, and they dirty. it was good times though.
There's actually also a drinking game going on online. Oh, every geez. Time you start saying or singing do-do, people are taking a drink.
Do-do-do-do-do.
All right. Has the pandemic inspired you to write anything?
It's inspired me to write things that kind of live in a dream that's outside of the pandemic. Like I do have one song that I wrote recently that has nothing to do with what has gone on in the past couple of the past year or whatever. And you know, it's a very hopeful song, I'm hoping I'm hoping that people can still make things that are not about this, and if we can go on and if we can make everybody safe and try and do the best we can for all the people around us, and also have a space set aside for the things that are not about that, that'll be fantastic.
What has been your favorite gig that you guys have played as a collective here?
In the Ice Castle? Yeah, the Snow King. We went to Illinois for the Snow King Festival. And they have every year they put on, the Snow King makes this castle. Not to knock Edmonton's Ice Castle, but this is a castle. This is a real castle. So the indoor performance space is almost this big. And it's powered and heated, and it's minus 40 outside, but we're still rock and rolling show. And that was a pretty sweet gig, yeah.
All right, so side question of my own here. Were you able to keep the guitars in tune while you're playing outside in an ice castle?
No. I mean, kind of. Yeah, but it's like you got to tune it on stage, because if you tune it in the heated dressing room, then you're going to come out and it's going to be different. And David, what keyboard were you using? That was weird, wasn't it? It was you used the little keyboard. Oh yeah, the other keyboard was frozen. That's right. So he used his little synth.
Are you going to be planning a tour involving the West Coast when things are back in motion?
Yes, I don't know. Definitely yes, I don't know. I owe these guys a tour out to the West Coast. We went to Seattle and I badly planned it. But we had a good time, but I do owe them a good time going out that way. So that'd be great to do that. Yeah.
Influential Edmonton artists.
Ooh. The Bens. I got a case of the Bens. I got Ben Spencer and Ben Suras. Definitely were And you know, I say influence, but like they're fantastic writers. I'm not a lyricist. I get in touch with the music of it, and I write lyrics for it. But those guys really inspire me. It's like I know there were some younger composers back in the day that had like a bust of Beethoven on their piano just to intimidate them, or either that, or maybe it was Beethoven had a bust of Bach or something on his piano, like to intimidate him into writing better. But that's what I'm gonna do: get a bust of the Benz.
All right, there's one question that's directed to us that I'll address after, but is there any shout outs that you'd like to give while you have the chance here before we get back into the music?
I'd like to shout out to the Northwest Territories. I think Mama Naba, you're out there watching the show probably. I love you guys. I hope everybody stays safe up there, out in the communities. And love you and miss you. Del and I hope you're doing well out there. And stay safe. Everybody in Edmonton, keep your calm. Keep doing what you're doing. That's thank you for doing what you've done so far.
So the last question that was more addressed to us individually is, what's the timeline looking like for venues like the Starlite to reopen? Right now, we are considered to be phase 3. There is nothing that is set for us to reopen as of right now. You know, Edmonton's been doing extremely well. I mean, if everyone is just still continuing to practice safe distancing, wash your hands, be kind to one another, I'm confident that it'll be sooner than later. But right now, there's no answer to that. So we're doing the best we can. We're very thankful for, you know, you guys playing tonight and everyone else that's been. This is, you know, still very special in a lot of ways. And thank you guys. So let's get back to the music here. And thank you once again.
Thanks, Tyson. I do want to send one more shout out to my wife Lana and all the other nurses out in the province. Lana, thank you for doing all the hard work that you do. I love you. Take care of me, and you're taking care of the rest of the province as well. It's tough work, and I work outside as well. I'm still working. We're both very thankful to be working at the same time. And we're also able to switch shifts so we can take care of our kids at the same time. And we're feeling pretty blessed and hoping that everybody else gets a fair shake at some point.
See you.
Duty, duty, do. Okay, I think we just got one or two more for you here. let's keep it up. Hope everybody's gets a good summer that day, regardless of what's going on. Thank you very much. Okay, we're going to do a little number off the Faster Than Light record. It's been lovely to not see you all out there in the World Wide Web. I'll see you sometime. But we're happy you're here nonetheless. Thank you, Andrew. Yes, that's right. Thanks, Starlite Room, for having us. And this is a gift, and I hope not to squander it. Peace, everybody. Gilday band. Andrew Stewart on the bass. Jeff O'Brien on the drums. Mr. David Aid on the keys. I am Jay Gilday. It's lovely to see you. I'll see you in the future. Peace.